Hey everybody, it's Brian with Everything X-Carve. Today, we're gonna make a waste board to keep this one nice and pretty. So stay tuned. So as you can see, I've already done a waste board. This is 24 inch by 24 inch. And I was having some projects that I needed to cut deeper and longer. As you can see with the laptop holder that I made, I went a little too deep. This is one of my first carves that I did. And so what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this and make it this size. So what we're using today is 0.75 of an inch MDF. I got this at one of the big box stores for, I think, 35 bucks for a 4x8 sheet. So what we're gonna do is we're going to go ahead and get this set up to where the holes are lining up directly like they would with the X-Carve. And then that way you can take an M5 threaded insert and we can put these in the holes. I'm not gonna go all the way through with the waste board. I'm gonna drill it out so I'm not ruining the waste board here. So it's a little bit of a tedious process, but in the end, my X-Carve factory waste board stays nice and I don't care what happens to this one. And we'll also get to level it out so we've got a nice, even, flat surface. So I'll show you how to do all that right now. So what I needed to do is I needed to take my 4x8 sheet. Wasn't 4x8 anymore because in the last video you saw that I'll post up here right now, I used it for my bit board storage. And so I have a lot of that MDF left. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna make another waste board that goes just an inch inside of these two holes here. So that way I've got a nice circumference all the way up to here. And so with that being said, we'll get going. I've cut this already. The measurement with the y-axis is 32.5 inches, and then the x-axis is 30.5 inches. So we'll get that up on the board, get that locked in, and then we'll go to the computer and show you how to set that up. I found a wasteboard hole pattern file from Michael Illingby on Inventables project site, which has been a huge help. So what I did is I adjusted the holes to center to the board so I could show you how to switch it up from the bottom of the actual wasteboard. So what we're going to do is we're going to control all. We're going to go to the shape. And we're going to move this, the x-axis, 2 inches over. And the y-axis, we're going to move to 1 inch. All right, so everything's set to go just how I want it. One thing to remember is always make sure that you're setting your depth properly in the cut section. I had mine set to 0.71 of an inch, which would require me to drill out the rest of it, but thereby saving my wasteboard from Inventables. On a side note, make sure that you mark your wasteboard square somewhere where you know where your starting point is. As you twist and turn this board, you might lose sight of where you're starting. So what I did is, once my dust boot got a little forward, I took that bottom left and I just put in the threaded insert and then removed it real quick so I could determine where my starting point was on the wood. Additional materials other than the wood needed for this waste board were to get some supplies from different areas. So I went to Amazon and I got these threaded inserts. These threaded inserts are M5 by 10 millimeters and they were about 10 bucks for 100 of these. The next I got this off of Harbor Freight for about $2. It's a 1/2 inch, 90 degree, 6-flute carbide countersink. Definitely does the job to get those threaded inserts below the wasteboard.
And then lastly, I had to make sure for my drill out, after carving the different holes, I had to get a 13 by 64 inch drill bit to finish drilling through the holes because I didn't want my wasteboard getting damaged beneath my sacrificial wasteboard. With this part, you don't need to worry about sanding it down or anything, because with this being the top, we're going to level this side, not the other side that we drilled up from. We'll flip it over and then we'll be able to use our countersink bit to get all the holes drilled in so the threaded inserts don't sit against the board, they're recessed in a little bit. You're not going to put a threaded insert in your four corners because this is where you're going to screw your sacrificial wasteboard into the factory wasteboard. I found the easiest way to organize your threaded inserts to make sure you don't have too many or too little is just to line them up next to the holes. When I first did this, I found that I was actually trying to put the threaded insert into one of my screw holes, which just didn't make sense. So this is the best way to do it, in my opinion. Now it's time to put the threaded insert in. You want to put your torque to about 4 on your drill, so that way you don't strip your MDF with the threaded insert. Next, you'll want to do a fill test to make sure that you're going flush or just below the MDF, so when you lay it down on your wasteboard, you don't have any warpage with your MDF. There's about 100 of these that you have to put in with this size of the board. Your hand will end up cramping up a little bit. I would highly recommend that you take a break here and there because it is a lengthy process to get all of those in. And don't forget, if they're not fit right, make sure that you get your countersink back in there to make sure it's flush. Now to do the four corners. I used a 1/2 inch spade bit and measured with electrician's tape up there to where I wanted to stop the drill, so it's only going 1/2 inch into the board, thereby still giving me 1/4 inch to screw down into the wasteboard. I purchased a Whiteside CNC spoilboard surfacing bit, 3-wing, 1/4 shank, 1-inch cut diameter, straight cut. I'll have the link down below if you want to know more about the bit. Also, the part number on this is 6210. I got this at Woodcraft, however, it's about $5 cheaper on Amazon, and I'll have that link down below. Another thing to mention is you always want to do this on just a sacrificial board. If it's your first time using a bit you've never used, so you know what to expect and how it's going to work. With this being my first time using a bit this big, I definitely wanted to make sure it was safe for me and it was not going to ruin all of the time and effort that I had already put into the project. Thank you. Now to level your waste board, first you'll want to set up the waste board in Easel by opening up a new project and telling the program what type of material you're wanting to use, as this is going to help determine your cut settings. The next step is to set the width and length of the board as well as its thickness. Once you've done this, you go over to the bit and select Other. If you are using the surface bit similar to mine, you will put in 1 inch. It is always good to check your cut settings for a custom cut to ensure that your settings are in a safe zone for operation. Next, create a square in Easel, set the width and height of the project in the size section of your shape tab. Adjust your project to your zero working position to make sure you have your cut set to the desired depth, which I'm using a 3/1000ths of an inch, then on the cut, have it set to fill. The carve on Easel's recommended settings took about 1 hour to do the whole surface of the waste board, and that's not too bad. I left it be. If you want, you can actually speed this up with the Easel overwrite settings to speed up your X and Y axis movement. Next, unclamp your board and set it into position, and then put the 4 screws in each corner. Now for the moment of truth. This screw should go all the way down to the top of the top waste board to guarantee and show that all of my holes are lined up correctly.
All right, so that's it for the waste board video. If you liked what you saw, give it a thumbs up. If you would like to see more of what I do, consider subscribing. Like I said, I'm not a professional at this. It's just me and my journey on how I'm using my X-Carve and showing you ideas of what you could do with yours, or if you're thinking about getting one. There's also a Everything X-Carve group on Facebook that has picked up a lot of traction. There's a lot of people there that have great ideas, great tips to help you out. So consider going and looking at that, that group as well. Great people. So that's it. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.